Welcome back to another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. In today's episode, we're going to talk about how you can prepare your cloud migration project and how you can use a tool from Microsoft called the Strategic Migration Assessment and Readiness Tool to be more efficient. Welcome back. My name is Thomas and I'm here with Tony, and we're going to discuss the Microsoft Strategic Migration Assessment and Readiness Tool to help with your cloud migration project. So before we actually dive in, Tony, into the tool itself, can you tell me a little bit why customers would want to migrate or modernize their infrastructure and their environment? Can you give us a couple of examples?
Absolutely, Thomas. And it's a great question to start with. So increasingly, we're seeing customers talk about migration and modernization, both of them together. You can see some of the reasons on the slide we're showing, but the key thing is it has to be the reason that's important for your organization, and that's going to be different based on the business that you're in. The real classic pattern that we see is that customers a lot of times want to start by addressing the basic thing of cost and getting out of the data center, getting out of those types of operations. Then they want to move on to, you know, once they've adopted the cloud, get new capabilities. So things like being able to scale up and scale down their applications. And then the last milestone is just getting on to new innovation, you know, perhaps bringing new services to market or, you know, finding insights about their customers that they didn't know before. So those are, you know, that's kind of the progression that we see. And, you know, it's just a really exciting time for customers in this space.
No, that's awesome. Absolutely. And my next question really would be around what are the challenges you're seeing with customers who want to migrate or modernize their environments? I understand that you're obviously pretty aware of these challenges and you created a tool to actually help those customers with that.
Yeah, the way we found out that customers were having some trouble with getting ready was actually through our program. We have this program called Azure Migration and Modernization Program, where we take customers through the entire journey. And that was our early indication that there was definitely some struggles with readiness. And so I think we saw three struggles. The first is really missing the early stage stuff, the strategy and planning, and making sure that that's solid. Next thing is thinking end to end about readiness. So early on, you know, importance of, you know, the strategy plan, how you're going to migrate, and then even thinking, what do I need to get ready post-migration? So thinking end to end. And then honestly, missing steps. As we'll go over in a few minutes, there's a lot of steps to, you know, address, and it's important to think about all of them.
Yeah, that's a good point. And again, you just mentioned there are a couple of steps you need to think of. So how does a migration project look like? Can you give us a little bit of an indication and a little bit of an example on that?
Absolutely. And this is going to be mapped directly to what you are going to see in the tool that we'll give a demo on in a few minutes. And the good news is that it's all based on the cloud adoption framework, which should be familiar to customers if they've already been on the Azure journey with us to some extent. So, you know, this is Cloud Adoption Framework, or CAF, starts with, you know, figuring out that strategy that I said is so important. And, you know, what are the motivations? Do you have funding secured? And just a loose sense of, you know, what's in scope for the project. You'll get into more detailed scope later. Then moving on to plan. So assessing your environment, figuring out exactly which applications are going to be in scope, and then what timing, when will they move to the cloud? Also really important, making sure that you have a skills readiness plan for your organization. So we'll talk about that in some more detail. Ready is also a really important step. So this is about mostly how you're going to set up your landing zone in Azure such that, you know, your workloads are going to land there in a well-architected destination. Adopt, you know, how are you going to exactly orchestrate the migration or modernization? Things like automation to make things go even faster as you get through latter stages. And then the stripe across the bottom, secure, manage, and govern. You know, this is what I mentioned, are the steps that you should think about, even though they're post-migration. So how are you going to set up, you know, a good backup and disaster recovery strategy for your applications? How are you going to ensure good governance through things like policies and blueprints? You know, those are services in Azure that you can start to leverage. So, you know, again, thinking end to end, but these are all, you know, called out in the tool that we'll look at in a few minutes. And so we're really thinking holistically about readiness.
No, that's pretty awesome. And again, I think that is really helpful to have all these steps, especially from the cloud adoption framework, and take that all into considerations, right? Because it's easy that people can forget certain things to think of. And with that tool, we can really help them. So it sounds like it's a pretty smart tool. Can you actually help us a little bit with that and show me a little bit about it?
Absolutely, Thomas. And I'd love to show you a demo here. So I'm going to start here at the Microsoft Docs page, Azure section. And if I go to the architecture tab here and I just go into assessments, this is where you can see that we have a variety of them available for you. So this is the one we're going to talk about today, strategic migration assessment and readiness tool. I'm going to start a new assessment. I'm just going to give you a quick sense for how easy this is to complete. It should be something that the migration project lead, someone in the project management office for the project, should be able to complete, or they should be able to reach out to some of their teammates to understand the answers to these. And it's not too overbearing. So just questions like, have you identified the compelling business reason, right? Kind of that, you know, one of those reasons from the slide we showed earlier. I'll just give a few more examples. Do you have executive fund or executive sign-off and funding? So we'll pick an answer here. So as you could see, you know, we're going after yes, no type of responses, or maybe just three choices. Another one is, you know, do you have a partner identified that's going to help you? And so, you know, again, you should be able to complete this in just a matter of a few minutes. So I'm going to now hop to a finished example of the assessment. And so you could see here that we have a number of different scores shown. And so an overall score is yellow, so moderate. You know, we got a score of 5 out of 10, and that's an average across all the dimensions. And you could see here that in the earlier stages, so things like the business strategy or partner support, were green. But in some of the middle of the project stages, such as doing a business case or developing the plan, were yellow, and maybe were red on a few of the latter stages. And this is totally normal and expected. In fact, it would be a little strange if you were green across the board. So the expectation is that we're identifying where you need to work on, and just surfacing how you can make these even better. So we don't just give you the scores. We're going to give you ways to improve. So you can go down here to the recommendation section, and I'll give you a few examples. So let's just start with discovery and assessment. We're a lot of times pointing you directly to Microsoft Docs. You know, these are articles that you can just reference directly, and we're just kind of cherry picking those ones for you that are going to help with making this green. So here's an example. You can head to this article about, you know, how to identify your migration scope. And then we also have another great resource for you on how to work on getting application owners aligned to having their applications move to Azure. Another really practical example is building your technical skilling plan. So in this case, again, we're yellow. But that's okay. So we're going to give you the resources that it takes to make this better. So we're pointing you to the free training that's out at Microsoft Learn. And a really great starting point is also the Azure Fundamentals course. And of course, you'll probably want to get a lot of your staff certified on Azure. We have a whole plethora of certifications, and so you can explore those. So the idea here is that we're surfacing what you can take action on, and you can hand off these recommendations to the team who's going to be able to do something about this.
Okay, no, this is pretty smart and very impressive, I think, to have all this information. And what I think is very important is it's not just when you think about migration, you often think just about technology, right? About how do I do actually the migration? But there's obviously, as you just showed, a lot more involved from business strategy and then also skilling wise. And the tool obviously takes care of like all of that. So you also showed me scores. My question now would be, do I need to have a high score to actually then start my project?
That's a great question. And it's a natural inclination for all of us to want to score highly on anything that we take. As I said, the answer is no. Like, it's expected that you would start this process with perhaps a red or a yellow score. The idea is that we're going to not just tell you that, you know, you're scoring yellow, but we're going to give you an action plan for how to improve it. What are the specific areas that you need to go work on in order to get that green? Another thing to call out is that it's not expected that you have to be green when you start the project, but as you get closer to moving through these phases of the project, they should be turning green. So while you don't have to have everything at the last mile steps figured out, by the time you get to the middle of the project, you should be figuring out, for example, how are you going to do management and governance for the new Azure workloads?
Oh, that's great. And you also showed me before that there are recommendations, right? And they looked pretty good. So can you tell me a little bit more how we could take these recommendations and what to do with it?
Sure. We make it really easy across all the Microsoft assessments. You could just simply copy the URL and send it to your team, in which case they would have access to the report that I just showed, and they can interact with the tool and all the recommendations. And then in the upper right-hand corner of the tool, we also have a number of share options. So you can email the report and they can also get it that way.
Oh, that's awesome. Again, it looks like the strategic migration assessment and readiness tool is really great and helps customers to really identify where they need to invest and think about in their migration project. So if I now want to learn more, where do I go?
Sure. We make it pretty easy. So the first thing you should do is go to the tool itself, and that is at aka.ms/smarttool. The next thing is, if you want to learn more about the topic of migration or modernization, we have a great resource for you called the Azure Migration and Modernization Center. So you can just go to your favorite search engine and search for that, or go to azure.com and it'll be there. And then the last thing is, we have a program for you. When you're ready to get started with help from Microsoft, we would love to engage with you. It's called the Azure Migration and Modernization Program, also available at azure.com/AMMP.
Oh, that is awesome. Thank you very much, Tony. And thank you very much to everyone watching. And don't forget to go to aka.ms/adopt.